The hardest part to get right about a character, I think, is the voice. When I'm struggling with a character, it's usually because I haven't locked in on the voice. I'm actually doing a new novel now, and I've done 6 drafts, and I've finally found this character's voice. And once the voice comes, it's almost as if every other aspect of that character comes clear. What he would wear, how he would speak, obviously, what kind of occupation, all of those things, and the character becomes real to me. I mean, it's almost as if I can hear that voice when I'm writing. So to me, as far as character development, that's where it really starts and where it begins, you know, where it begins, but also where it ends with me, with the voice, and the other things seem to fall into place. I mean, there are times, though, when, for instance, creating a character that I will do have certain visual aspects that I hope will give the character something as far as development as well. Sometimes it's a name. In Serena, there are a couple of names I felt really good about. I thought Galloway was a perfect name for a man who, in a sense, is an executioner who would lead people to the gallows, to death. Serena was a name I thought really worked actually on about 3 or 4 levels. It would be an exotic name in Western North Carolina, set her farther apart. It would also be a name, and there is, in a sense, she is both serene and not serene. She's, you know, the idea of serenity with a woman who is so dynamic is ironic, but at the same time, she does have a serenity about her in that she's never flustered. And the final thing was that I hope that some readers might actually make the connection between Serena and Selena, who is a goddess of the moon. And if you read the book, you'll notice that a lot of what Serena does when there's something really diabolical that's done at night.